So hi guys, good evening. I welcome you all for the fifth part of the 50 protected areas in the new series. So in this series, we'll be identifying 50 protected areas from the previous year's current affairs, and we are discussing those protected areas with respect to prelims point of view. Already I've discussed 40 protected areas in four parts. This is fifth part. So today we'll be discussing another 10 protected areas. So without any delay, let us go and see the last final 10 protected areas for the day. So today we are going to see these 10 protected areas: Udanti, Siddhanti, Ashola, Bhatti, Galeta Bay, Satkoshia. So these are all the protected areas. We are not going to see state wise, but we are going to see assorted. Since it is the last 10, I made it assorted, made it in an assorted way. So let us go for the first protected areas, that is Udanti Siddhanti Tiger Reserve. This Udanti Siddhanti Tiger Reserve is located in Chhattisgarh. Okay. So thousands of tribal people located in the core areas of the Siddhanti and Udanti Tiger Reserve are protesting. And they are demanding for recognition of community forest rights. So Siddhanti is a separate river and Udanti is a separate river. These two rivers are creating a valley, and that river, in and around the river valley, there is a protected area, and that area is having tiger. So it was declared as a tiger reserve. So people in that particular region, they are demanding for the community forest resource rights. So community forest resource rights means a community living in the forest area are given certain basic historical rights. See, these tribal communities are living in the forest areas, and they are living harmoniously with the animals for thousands of years in the nature. But now we are bringing in a law for protection of wildlife, and we are removing these people who are living historically from the forest areas outside in the name of a wildlife protection law. But they are not harm for the wildlife. Only humans who are coming from outside, they are harm for the wildlife, not the tribal people, tribal humans who are in this forest. So through Forest Protection Act, government decided to provide the forest rights to the people who are dwelling inside the forest area. And that is called as, so those rights are given in two ways. One is individual forest right and another is community forest right. Individual forest right is given to a particular individual, and community forest right is given to as a community as a whole. So that is a difference, and there are two different categories. And since this Udanti Wildlife Sanctuary and Siddhanti Wildlife Sanctuary merged and it was converted into a tiger reserve, these people couldn't continue to live there. So now they are demanding for the community forest resource rights, and they are asking for the government the permission to take the minority forest produced from the forest. So it is given under Scheduled Tribes and Other Traditional Forest Law, Recognition of Forest Rights Act, or in simple it is called as Forest Rights Act 2006. So under this Forest Rights Act 2006, they are giving this community rights to the people. Forest rights are either the tribe can be forest dwelling scheduled tribe or the traditional forest dwellers. So other traditional forest dwellers means even though some people, even though the non-tribal people also will be living in the forest, so they are other traditional forest dwellers. Tribes living in the forest is a different thing. Sometimes non-tribal people also will be living there, so they are other traditional forest dwellers, and both are entitled for community forest resource rights. What is this community forest resource right? That community as a whole can enter the forest and take certain minority forest produce like honey. They can do small tree cutting. So it strengthens the conservation regime of the forest while ensuring the livelihood and food security of the forest dwelling scheduled tribes and traditional forest dwellers. So when these people are in the forest, they will also protect the environment. They will not harm the environment. So that is the logic here. And Gram Sabha is the initial authority which will provide these rights to these people. So these people living in this tiger reserve are asking for this particular rights here. Okay. That is the issue behind this Udanti Siddhanti Tiger Reserve. So tribal people living there are asking for the rights. Now let us see about the Tiger Reserve there. Siddhanti Udanti Tiger Reserve came into existence in 2008-09. Are two separate reserves. That is Udanti and Siddhanti Wildlife Sanctuary. They were combined together to create a reserve in Chhattisgarh. It contains various types of forest. So one famous forest which you have to note is salt forest. So the salt trees located here has created this salt forest. Asiatic wild buffalo is the key endangered species in the core area. So Asiatic wild buffalo, note down the name of the species. So apart from tigers, it is also having Asiatic wild buffalo. So there can be a question. Asiatic wild buffalo is naturally found in which of the following protected areas? So it is there in Udanti Siddhanti Tiger Reserve. Apart from tiger, other endangered and rare species are Indian wolf, leopard, sloth bear, and mouse deer. So these are all the other species which are found there naturally. So what are all the rivers? So Siddhanti River originates in the middle of Siddhanti Wildlife Sanctuary. It's a tributary of Mahanadi River. So Siddhanti River, which is passing through this region, is a tributary of Mahanadi River. And Udanti River, from west to east, covering major part of the Udanti Wildlife Sanctuary, is also a tributary of Tail River. See, Siddhanti is directly the tributary of Mahanadi, but this Udanti River meets the Tail River. This Tail River in turn meets the Mahanadi. So it is a sub-tributary of Mahanadi. Siddhanti is a direct tributary of Mahanadi, but Udanti is a sub-tributary of Mahanadi. So that is the thing which you have to note from this particular thing. So, and this is the map here, and we are having Udanti and Siddhanti here. Okay. So if you could note here, here we are having Udanti, here we are having Siddhanti, and this Udanti River will come here and it will merge with the Udanti River will come here and it will merge with the Tail River, and this Tail River will in turn go and merge with the Mahanadi River, and Siddhanti will directly go and meet with the Mahanadi. So these are all the two protected areas here. So let us continue with the second protected area, that is Asolabhatti Wildlife Sanctuary. This Asolabhatti Wildlife Sanctuary is located in Delhi. So it is one protected area which is located in the National Capital Territory region. So National Capital Territory region of Delhi. So Delhi Forest Department will conduct first ever wildlife census. So they are going to conduct the wildlife census in the Asolabhatti Wildlife Sanctuary in the National Capital this year. And the focal point is leopards. So this Asolabhatti is known for its leopards, and in and around Delhi there are a lot of leopards, and this Asolabhatti is also having leopards there. And this forest wildlife census is going to cover leopard in special. So whenever government is doing any species census, we have to watch that, because questions are arising from the census. Already we saw about the leopard census in another protected area, and now again we are seeing it again. So in the first edition of the video itself, we discussed about the leopard census. So go back and see that. Asolabhatti Wildlife Sanctuary is a 32 square kilometer area lying in the southern Delhi ridge of Aravalli Hill Range. So Aravalli Hill Range, so if you could see, so if this is the rough India and we are having Delhi here. So Aravalli Hill starts from Gujarat here and it continues like this. And here we are having the Delhi Ridge. So Delhi Ridge is a region which is located here like this. And in this Delhi Ridge only, we are having this Asolabhatti Wildlife Sanctuary. This Aravalli Hill Range is one of the oldest mountain system. Okay. So it is very oldest mountain system, and Himalayas is the youngest one, and Aravalli is the oldest one. That's why it has denuded and weathered a lot, and it is now just its altitude is just small now because of a lot of weathering and denudation which take place over the millions of years. An area of 1 kilometer around Asolabhatti Wildlife Sanctuary was also declared as an eco-sensitive zone. So that is another reason why it was in news. Wildlife habitats inside the sanctuary acts as the water recharge zone for Delhi. So it collects the water. So it is a catchment area which collects the water for the it sends this water to the underground, and it fills the aquifers for the Delhi. So it is a very important protected area with respect to the water availability for Delhi. Biodiversity significance of the ridge lies in the merger of Indo-Gangetic plain. It is also joining with the Indo-Gangetic plain and is also part of the northern Aravalli leopard corridor. So already we saw about the tiger corridor, and this is about the leopard corridor. So leopard corridor means it is connecting the habitats of leopards so that leopards can move from one protected area to another protected area without any difference. So see, there will be a protected area here. There will be a protected area here. In between, we'll be having the human habitat. We'll be having a city here. We'll be having another city here or a village here. If a leopard wants to go out of it, it will come into contact with humans, and that will lead to human-animal conflict. So leopard corridor means connecting these two regions with a green lush area so that this leopard can move from this region to this region without coming into the human region, human area. So creating a corridor between two protected areas called as leopard corridor, and they have created it for elephant, they have created it for tigers, and here we are seeing about one for leopard. It's an important wildlife corridor which starts in the Sariska National Park of Rajasthan. From Sariska of Rajasthan, it continues through Faridabad and Gurugram districts of Haryana to Delhi Ridge. So from Sariska in Rajasthan till Delhi, we are having this leopard corridor, and it is important part of this leopard corridor, and it is an important habitat of the Indian leopard. Yes, endangered species red-headed vulture and Egyptian vulture is also located in this particular protected area. So Asolabhatti is not only known for leopards but also for the vultures. What are the two types of vulture? That is red-headed vulture and Egyptian vulture. So here I'm showing an infographic which discuss about the areas which are allowed, banned and regulated in the eco-sensitive zone. So once a region is declared as an eco-sensitive zone, so eco-sensitive zone is a buffer area in and around a protected area. So which are all the things which is banned? Commercial mining is banned, stone quarrying is banned, crushing units of rocks, polluting industries, discharge of untreated effluent and sawmills and bricklayers. All these things are totally banned. We have to remember this. Then regulated activities. So these activities are completely banned, but these activities are allowed in a regulated scale. That is, hotels and resorts are allowed. construction is allowed, small scale non-polluting industries allowed. See, polluting industries are banned, non-polluting small scale industries are allowed, but non-polluting large industries are not allowed. So that is the thing which you have to note. Then felling of trees is allowed in a regulated way. Civic infrastructure, people can live, and commercial extraction of water is also available. And these activities are openly allowed. That is rainwater harvesting, organic farming, cottage industries, use of renewable energy, agroforestry, and any eco-friendly transport. All these things are allowed. So you have to memorize these things, because UPSC will tend to ask question, which of the following are allowed in an eco-sensitive zone, or which of the following is banned in an eco-sensitive zone. So you give priority and read the banned elements. So if you are reading this banned elements, most probably you can guess the answer in any way UPSC asks, because something from this area will also be listed there to confuse us, and we can easily identify. So whenever you are studying these lists, study the negative list, because that is easy to so whichever is short one that you have to read, and here read this negative list, because with the negative list we can easily guess the right answer. So memorize these things, which are the activities which are allowed. And this is the map of Delhi, National Capital Territory. And see, here we are having Haryana. So this Faridabad region, here we are having Haryana. So in the Haryana-Delhi border, we are having this Asholabaddi Wildlife Sanctuary. So here we are having UP, and this is Haryana, and this is Delhi. So this is completely Haryana. So this entire region is Haryana. And in the southeastern region of Delhi, we are having this Asholabaddi Wildlife Sanctuary. So next is Galathea Bay Sanctuary. This Galathea Bay Sanctuary is located in the Great Nicobar. So that is in the Andaman and Nicobar Islands. That is, and in especially it is located in the Great Nicobar. Great Nicobar is the southernmost tip of India. So it is having the Indira Point, which is the southernmost tip of India. So why this Galathea Bay is in news? Because government, that is Niti Aayog, has launched a holistic and sustainable vision for Great Nicobar Island. So they have brought in a vision document which talks about the holistic and sustainable development of Great Nicobar Island, so that it is also providing the economic development in a sustainable way, that is through sustainable development, and also they are aiming at improving the livelihood of the people living there. So economic development and livelihood improvement of the people. What they are going to focus? They are going to focus tourism activities, and they are going to focus shipping sector. So shipping is one thing which you are going to focus. Another thing is tourism activity. These are all the two focus areas of this particular vision document. So because of this announcement, government is planning to construct a lot of shipping and port in the region. So the proposal includes international container transshipmental terminal. So I'll tell you why they are constructing this international container transshipment terminal there. I'll talk about it when I show the map. And a greenfield international airport. They are also planning to construct an international airport there, international container terminal there, and a power point and a township, everything in the Nicobar region. So that is the government's plan, so that to provide economic development and to livelihood opportunity, employment opportunity for the people, because Nicobar region is a backward region. So and because of in order to implement this, what National Board of Wildlife, this they denotified the Galathea Bay Wildlife Sanctuary, so that if there is a wildlife sanctuary there, you cannot construct any port. See, in the eco-sensitive zone itself, you cannot construct a port. Then how we can construct a port in a wildlife sanctuary? So what National Board of Wildlife did, National Board of Wildlife is chaired by the Prime Minister. In previous video, I would have said Environment Minister. So National Board of Wildlife is headed by Prime Minister. So government has denotified this entire Galathea Bay Wildlife Sanctuary, which means that they are denotifying this region to allow an economic activity there. And that has led to a protest in that particular region. So people are protesting against this particular move of the government. So environmentalists there are protesting against, because it is having a lot of keystone species. I'll talk about that later. Government announced this National Marine Turtle Action Plan. So under this Marine Turtle Action Plan, government is protecting this turtle species. So one of the turtle species which is located in Galathea Bay is giant leatherback turtle. So this leatherback turtle, since it is found here, they have also listed this region as important coastal and marine biodiversity area and important marine turtle habitat. So under this action plan, they will be declaring sites as important marine turtle habitats and important marine biodiversity area. So since it is having this turtle species, they have declared this region as important marine turtle habitat. Like we discussed important bird area in the previous video. So on the similar line, they are declaring it as important marine turtle habitat, which means that marine turtles will be protected there. So at one side, they are telling that marine turtle will be protected there and it is an important marine turtle area. On the another side, government is contradicting itself by denotifying this particular sanctuary and allowing a port there. So these two are contradicting with each other, and that has created a confusion. So for two reasons, the entire thing is in news. And this is the map of the Andaman and Nicobar Islands. And now I would like to show. So this is Andaman and Nicobar Islands. And here only we are having the Indonesia and Malaysia. So which means that Malacca Strait is located here. So Malacca Strait is one of the important choking point for the international shipping. So from this Malacca Strait, Of course, it is further south, but since I'm for the map convenience, I'm drawing here. The important ships shipping route is there. So if we construct an international port terminal here, all the ships which are coming here will have a stopover here. So if they are having a stopover here, generally they will buy the, they'll refuel the ship. They will refuel the needs of the people who are in the ship, other than the food needs and other needs, and the logistical business will develop. So because it is an international route, they want to develop an international port there that will be acting as a port of call. Port of call na, international ship will be coming there and stopping there in order to refuel their logistics. So adanalae economic activity will grow. And since international ships are coming there, we need an international airport also. Because it is an island, it is not connected to mainland India. So we need an island to go to Andaman or to go to any other. When you are having an international port there, you need an international airport also, because some captains from the international ship might go to the airport and go to their own country. So adanalae da vandu they're constructing both in this region, and this has created a very big problem. So strategically we need a port there because it is having a business potential, but it is threatening the species. So I have zoomed in this particular map. So from this map we have zoomed the Great Nicobar, which is the southernmost point, and inside this Great Nicobar we are having Galathea Bay National Park. Okay, so this is North Andaman, Middle Andaman, South Andaman, Little Andaman, and here we are having Great Nicobar, and here we are having Little. So this is Little Nicobar and this is Car Nicobar. So Car Nicobar and Little Andaman. So in between two, we are having 10 degree channel. So this is the brief map of Galathea Bay. So Rahul Akshaya, I'm telling that, yeah. So giant leatherback turtle is the most famous turtle, and Nicobar megapod. So these are all the two important species. Both the species are vulnerable, okay? Both giant leatherback turtle and Nicobar megapod are vulnerable, and they both are located in this particular region. So this is the giant leatherback turtle and this is Nicobar megapod. Nicobar megapod is a bird. It is a bird here, and it is a turtle. See, it is called giant because it grows as huge as a human. மனுஷங்களோட கூட பெரிய பெருசா வளர வாய்ப்பு இருக்கு. ஸோ சி தி சைஸ் ஹியர், ஐ எம் கம்பேரிங் வித் கம்பேரிட் வித் ஹியூமன் சைஸ். ஸோ இட் இஸ் அ வெரி ஜெயின் டர்டில். ஸோ திஸ் டர்டிலோட நெஸ்டிங் சைட் இஸ் லொக்கேட்டட் தட் ஜஸ்ட் லைக் ஹவு தி வி ஆர் ஹேவிங் இன் ஒடிஷா. ஒடிஷாவில் வந்து ஹவு வி ஆர் ஹேவிங் கஹீர் மாதா வைல்ட் லைஃப் சாங்சுரி ஆஸ் தி நெஸ்டிங் கிரவுண்ட் ஃபார் ஆலிவ் ரிட்லி டர்டில். இது வந்து கலேத்தியா பே இஸ் அ நெஸ்டிங் சைட் ஃபார் ஜெயின் லெதர் பேக் டர்டில். அண்ட் திஸ் ரீஜன் இஸ் ஆல்சோ பார்ட் ஆஃப் கிரேட் நிக்கோபார் அண்ட் சுண்டா பயோஸ்பியர் ரிசர்வ். So, and it is also biodiversity hotspot. It is also part of the biodiversity hotspot. That is Great Nicobar and Tunda region. And we are also having tribal groups there. We are having two tribal groups. One is a Champan tribal groups and other one is Nicobaris tribal groups. These both Champan and Nicobaris are Mongolian tribal groups, and they both are living in this particular protected area. Okay. So, note down the name of the species, name of the tribes, and the Niti Aayog's document. Because see, with Lakshadweep, we are having an issue with respect to a different government regulation. With Nicobar, we are having a different issue with a different government regulation. So in both the islands, we are having an issue. So we can expect a question from island protection this year. So next one is Satkoshia Tiger Reserve. Satkoshia Tiger Reserve was chosen as the Tiger Reserve for the translocation of tiger. Okay. So India's first interstate translocation of tiger project was initiated in the Satkoshia Tiger Reserve. That is, they chose a male tiger called Mahavir from Kanha Tiger Reserve and a female tiger named Sundari from Bandargav Tiger Reserve. So from Bandargav, they chose Sundari, and from Mahavir from Kanha, they brought these two tigers to Satkoshia Tiger Reserve of Odisha. So idu rendu vandu Madhya Pradesh la irukku, Kanha and Bandargav, and Satkoshia is located in Odisha. They brought it to Odisha to shore up the tiger population, because Satkoshia there was dwindling tiger population. So they brought these tigers to Satkoshia. But now what happened, they never introduced it. They just brought it in cage and they just kept the cage because people started to protest. Yena, so people in and around the Satkoshia Tiger Reserve, they started to protest because if a tiger is being introduced, the number of tiger population will rise, and they are fearing that will increase the human-animal conflict or unwanted disturbance for the human activity. So they were protesting. For the past 2 years, they are protesting. They initiated it in 2018. For the past 2 years, they were protesting. This issue was never settling down. And the Sundari and Mahavi, they were locked in the cages forever in Gramari, cage layer. So you cannot lock animals for a long period of time in cage. So what they decided to bring back these tigers to their own mother habitat. And government decided to suspend this particular tiger translocation temporarily. So why they wanted to translocate? So, why did they translocate? Because See, at one side, see, we are having tiger habitat. In this tiger habitat, the region is declining. So since the tiger habitat region is declining, what is happening? The same number of tigers will have to live in a small region. So because of this, they are having territorial dispute. So tigers la vandha the territorial la vaaluvaanga. They will not allow another tiger to enter their own territory. So the territorial dispute adhigamaayitt irukkanaala infighting of tigers is increasing. Because of this infighting of tiger, many animals are getting killed. So since human are encroaching the tiger lands, tiger are going or confined to a small region. So that is a major problem. So anala enna pandranga, they are taking the tiger from this region and they are shifting those tigers to the another protected area. Okay, so that is the main aim here. Recently, Tiger Sundari was translocated back to MP mainly because of the protests going on. So Satpoosha is located in Odisha and it was declared a tiger reserve in 2007. Okay, it had 12 tigers, but it reduced to 2 in the 2018 tiger census. In the 2018 tiger census, the population reduced to 2, and that's why they wanted to increase it by reintroduction. And it is also having huge potential to increase the tiger population because Satpoosha has a large area, but they are having only 2 tigers. So Kanha is having a huge number of tigers, but the area is small. So they wanted to take a few tiger from Kanha and Bandargaon and introduce in the Satpoosha. So that is the logic here. So Satpoosha is having a unique feature, that is the river Mahanadi cuts through this particular region and creates a beautiful gorge. So what is a gorge? So if you will be having a mountain, if at all a river is cutting through it, what will happen? Over the period of time, this river will erode this mountain and that will lead to a valley kind of a formation. So this is called as a gorge. I'm showing you the front view. Gorge na, and then the canyon mari varadha vandu, it is the gorge. Mahanadi is cutting through this particular eastern ghats. So Mahanadi enna pannadhi, it is cutting through this eastern ghats. Since it's cut through the eastern ghats, it created a beautiful gorge. In the beautiful gorge suthi da vandu, we are having the Satpoosha Tiger Reserve. So Satpoosha Gorge Sanctuary and Baisipalli Sanctuary. These two sanctuaries together, they were combined to create this Satpoosha Tiger Reserve. And this is the map here. If you could see, we are having Satpoosha in this region. So if you could see from Udanti Siddhanti, Mahanadi used to come like this. And from Udanti Siddhanti, we are having this tail river coming and joining. We discussed in the previous slide. And this is the Google Maps. Here, if you see, this is Satpoosha and this is the Mahanadi River. This Mahanadi River is cutting through this region and going to the Bay of Bengal. Next, we are going to see about Nanda Devi Biosphere Reserve. Nanda Devi Biosphere Reserve is in news because of the avalanche which took away a lot of tribes. So, we are having this Dauli Ganga and Rishi Ganga River, which are all the tributaries of Alaknanda River system. In this Dauli Ganga River, what we had? We had a glacial lake outburst. Glacial lake outburst flood. That is called as GLOF. GLOF na glacial lake outburst flood. So because of this glacial lake outburst flood, see a glacier kitta or lake mari form a irukum, because of melting of glacier that will create a flood suddenly in the region, flash flood. So because of that flash flood, what happened in this Dauli Ganga region, we are constructing a hydroelectric power project. This hydro project was under construction in Dauli Ganga. Because of the sudden flood, the entire project was washed away and a lot of people were dying. So that's why this took place in the Nanda Devi. So this took place in the Nanda Devi Glacier, which is having this Nanda Devi, which is part of this Nanda Devi Biosphere Reserve. And the Biosphere Reserve kulle idu nadandanaala da this issue is in news. So this Dauli Ganga and Rishi Ganga are part of Alaknanda. So that is one thing which you have to note. Nanda Devi National Park and Nanda Devi Biosphere Reserve is established in 1982. And it is in and around the surrounding of the Nanda Devi Peak. So Nanda Devi Peak inge irukku. This peak is almost 7,800 meter high. So idu sutti vandu they have declared this region as Nanda Devi Biosphere Reserve. So in the region oda height is just 3500 meter. Aduk nadula there will be a peak. Okay, so it is also having this Valley of Flowers National Park, which is also a World Heritage Site. So it is also a Biosphere Reserve. It is a World Heritage Site, and it is a transition zone from the Zaskar Range to Great Himalayan Range. So these are all the ranges of Himalaya. Zaskar Range is a separate range, Great Himalaya is separate, and it is a transition zone between the two. These are all the vegetations which are growing there. Okay, so grassy slopes, alpine meadows na bhugyalsan they will be calling in the local language, alpine meadows and snow covered areas. It is also having snow, it is also having meadows. Okay, that is the thing which you have to note. And several important mammal species in the snow leopard. You are having snow leopard in the Nanda Devi. So that is the thing which you have to note, because which of the following regions are having snow leopard, they can ask. Himalayan black bear, brown bear and musk bear. So last time there was a question from musk deer. Which of the following is having musk deer? Into UPSC 2020, they asked the question. Which of the following protected areas having musk deer? Like that, they can ask a question. Which of the following protected areas are having snow leopard? So that is the thing which you have to note. So local community vandu Bhotia community is living there. So that is a Indo-Mongoloid tribe. Okay, the tribal name is Bhotia. So this is the map of the Uttarakhand, and if you could note, this is the Nanda Devi. So already we discussed about the Gangotri, and we discussed Rajaji, we discussed the Jim Corbett. Now we are discussing the Nanda Devi Biosphere Reserve. And if you could see here, we are having the Alaknanda River here. We are having Valley of Flowers here. And this is the map which I wanted to discuss, which is a very important thing. Since we had a flood here in Dhauli Ganga, in the Dhauli Ganga Lada, we are having the flood now. Okay. And the entire accident took place here. This Dhauli Ganga is a tributary of Alaknanda. And this Dhauli Ganga is meeting Alaknanda in Vishnu Prayag. And Nandagini is another tributary which is meeting Alaknanda in Nand Prayag. Okay. Since Nandagini River, Nand Prayag. Then we are having Pindar River. Pindar River is joining Alaknanda in the Karna Prayag. And then we are having Mandagini in the Rudra Prayag. See, Nandagini na Nand, Mandagini na Rudra Prayag. Nandagini naale and the part of the neighbor. Mandagini, Manganini, Sindamani, Baba Hamsaveni, Wali Oda lyrics, there will be a song. So that Mandagini River is mixing the Alaknanda in the Rudra Prayag. So Mandagini na Rudra Prayag, Nandagini na Nand Prayag, Pindar is Karna Prayag, Dhauli Ganga is Vishnu Prayag. And finally, River Bhagirathi meets Alaknanda in the Deva Prayag. So from this Deva Prayag only, we are the river called Ganga is formed. Okay. So Bhagirathi is a river which originates from Gangotri. So Gangotri lindu Bhagirathi varo. Here we are having Alaknanda. These two rivers will join to form Ganga River. So this is very important. Note down the in the Prayag regions also you have to note, and note down the name of the tributaries also. UPSC can ask question in any way. So if you could see here in real time, this is the Bhagirathi River which is coming here, and here we are having Alaknanda River. Alaknanda River inge varudhu, Bhagirathi River inge varudhu. So these are all the two rivers which we are discussing about. So next one is Netravali Wildlife Sanctuary. So Netravali Wildlife Sanctuary, Patida, next we are going to see. A black panther was spotted in the Goa's Netravali Wildlife Sanctuary. So that's why it is in news. Okay. Black panther na, again, it is not the movie of Marvel, but it is a normal leopard or a normal jaguar which is having this melanistic disease. Avangalude skin la melanin content will be high. So that since they are having this melanistic issue, their entire skin will become black. So that is the problem. It is not a separate species. Because of this melanin issue, it is having this problem. Okay. So recently a black panther was spotted in the Netravali Wildlife Sanctuary of Goa. Okay. This is having tigers. Now for the first time, we are having a black panther also spotted in the camera. So idha the black panther, our camera trap light got, it came near this water area to drink water, and it was spotted. So in India, this black panthers are naturally found in the Kabini Wildlife Sanctuary of Karnataka, Anshi Dandeli Sanctuary of Karnataka, Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve of Tamil Nadu, Namurli Irukku, Tadoba Andari of Maharashtra, and Netravali of Goa. In all these regions, we are having black panther. So in which of the following protected area the black panther is found? So this is a model of question which UPSC can ask. Okay. So that is the one thing which you have to note. Black panther is a melanistic color variant of any panthera. So it can be a leopard, it can be a jaguar. So once this leopard or jaguar is having increased melanin content, then that leads to a black panther. So ademari white tiger is not a separate species. It is a normal tiger which is having skin deficiency that leads to white tiger. Melanism is increased development of dark pigment, dark color pigment called melanin. Okay. So it is mainly found in the densely forested areas. So black panthers are found in the densely forested areas. So this is one reason why the Netravali is in news. Another reason why Netravali is in news, because a new ant species, pudusa or erumba vandu kandupidichirukanga, a new ant species, it is found in the Netravali. So it is an underground ant. Underground ant na, it never comes to the ground, it is always under the ground, it lives under the mud. So adanalo vandu it always lives within the mud, it never comes to the ground. Adanalo it is also blind ant. In the ant ku vandu kannu illa, or blind ant species, because underground la irukadnala it doesn't need an eye. It just moves with the senses. Okay. An underground species. Its name is Vibaus protanella. So the ant or a species or a name on the Vibaus protanella. So Vibaus would have been a scientist in the research. So they would have given the name. Okay. It is an underground species and seldom seen above the ground. Okay. So it is a rare group of ant, of which only 12 species were known in the worldwide. And now we have found a 13th species. So 13 underground ant species are found. Adala vandu 12 da vandu idu varaikku irundhadu. Now 13th species we have found here. So this is that particular ant species. See, it is not having any eye here. Okay. So that is the speciality. So we saw Black Panther spot panirukanga and new ant species also being found. So that is the reason why Netravali is in news. Netravali sanctuary is located in the southeastern Goa. Okay. And Kottigao Wildlife Sanctuary is in the southern side and Bhagavan Mahavir is in the northern side. We just now discovered about the Bhagavan Mahavir sanctuary in the first edition of the video. And now we are discussing another one in the Goa, that is the Netravali. So Netravali or Netruli is an important tributary of River Zuari. River Zuari is a river which originates in the Western Ghats. So Western Ghats originate or a river. It flows inside the Goa. It cuts Goa into two and it joins the Arabian Sea. So on the river, one of the tributaries is Netravali River. So Netravali is a river from where the entire wildlife sanctuary is getting the name. So most of the cases, these wildlife sanctuaries are getting the name mainly because of the river. Savari and Mainappi. Mainappi are the two waterfalls located here and it is having evergreen and semi-evergreen forests. Okay, evergreen and semi-evergreen forest. So leopard, giant squirrel, mouse deer, Nilgiri wood pigeon, Ceylon frog mouth. These are normal species, but main are Black Panther, tiger, and now we saw leopard, and then now ant. So these are all the things. And this is the Google Maps snapshot out of the Google Maps. So in the north we are having Bhagavan Mahavir, in the south we are having Kottigao, in the center we are having Netravali Wildlife Sanctuary. Towards the right we are having Ansi National Park of this one, Karnataka, and here we are having Bhimgad National Park. This Bhimgad National Park is part of again Karnataka, Bhimgad Wildlife Sanctuary and Ansi National Park. Okay, so note down these two things. Next, we are going to see about the Filbit Tiger Reserve. Filbit Tiger Reserve is part of Uttar Pradesh. Okay, this Filbit Tiger Reserve recently got an award for international award for T into two. T into two means tigers into two. So T into 2 means it is the target given by the St. Petersburg Declaration. So St. Petersburg is a city in Russia. There the Tiger Range countries signed a declaration that they will be doubling the tiger's population by 2022. So 2022 kula tiger's population double pananum. Adha vandha allarka target. So in the T into 2, doubling of numbers of tigers, Filbit has doubled the number of tigers. So it got the award for doubling it in a quick way. Again, on the international awards, best conservation excellence award, that is best protected areas, conservation excellence award. So, those regions which double the population, they will be getting T into 2 doubling award. And those regions which are having one of the excellent ways to protect that region is given the conservation excellence award, and that went to the Transboundary Manas Conservation Area. So Transboundary Manas Conservation Area, I already discussed about Manas. Manas is a tiger reserve which is shared by both India and Bhutan, and it is transboundary since it is beyond boundary. So these two protected areas got the award. Okay. And 2018's tiger census is also under the Guinness record for having one of the largest camera traps ever for any animal census. So award winners are announced in 23rd November 2020, 10th anniversary of T into 2 goal. Okay. So in 2012, they signed this Petersburg Declaration. Within 10 years, they were aiming to double the tiger's population. And these sites are going to get the financial grant also. So this Filbit and the Manas are also going to the financial grant for their best efforts. So Filbit is located in Uttar Pradesh. Okay. Lakhmipur Kheri district of Uttar Pradesh. It is in the northern edge of Indo-Nepal border. Okay. And it is also having Sharda and Khakra River. Already we saw Dudhwa National Park of this Uttar Pradesh. It is nearby this Dudhwa only. Dudhwa is in the Ghagra River and Filbit is in the Sharda River. Sharda River is a river which divides the, which demarcates the India-Nepal border. In 2015, it was declared as the Tiger Reserve. It is one of the excellent example of Terra Ecosystem. Terra Ecosystem is a marshy land between the, in the foothills of Himalayas where the Ganges River goes into the underground and comes out. So that is the Terai region, which is a marshy region. So it is having tiger, swamp deer. Because it is a swamp region, it is also having a swamp deer, Bengal florican, hawk deer and leopards. So salt forest again. It is a Terai ecosystem with salt forest. So salt tree in Arya Arkara region. So that is one thing which you have to note. Okay. So we are seeing a lot of salt forest in the protected areas. So here we saw Dudhwa. See, in Dudhwa we had this Ghagra River. And this is Filbit. So Filbit is located in the UP, Uttarakhand and Nepal tri-junction. Here we are in Nepal, here we are in Uttarakhand and here we are in UP. All these three regions meets in the Filbit Tiger Reserve. This is the Sharda River. Actually, the Sharda River only demarcates the Uttarakhand and Nepal border. that is India-Nepal border. So it is located in the banks of the Sharda River. So next is Sri Lankameshwara Wildlife Sanctuary. Sri Lankameshwara nu paathona Sri Lanka nu na you will be thinking it is located in Sri Lanka. No, but this Sri Lankameshwara Wildlife Sanctuary is located in Andhra Pradesh. Andhra la Sri Lankameshwara Wildlife Sanctuary is there. It is a wildlife sanctuary headquartered in the Kadapa. It is located in the Kadapa district of Andhra Pradesh. It is the only habitat in the world which is having this Jerdon's Couser. Jerdon's Couser is a highly endangered bird species. It is a critically endangered bird species which was thought to be extinct. It was thought to be extinct in 1980s. In 1980s, a particular researcher found this bird back. His name is Jagannathan, I think, and he found this bird back. And again, on the it got the critically endangered status. It came from extinct to critically endangered status. So this Jerdon's Couser, again, it was spotted in the Sri Lankameshwara Wildlife Sanctuary. This Couser is a restricted range endemic, mainly found in the eastern ghats of Andhra Pradesh. So this particular region, see, we all know Kadapa is part of the eastern ghats. It is thought to be extinct and it was rediscovered in 1986. So it is having a dry deciduous mix. Yeah, eastern ghats is mostly having dry deciduous forest and mixed thorn forest. So red santas, semmara kattaigal, is also found here. Red santas is an endemic species to the eastern ghats. So red santas are naturally found in eastern ghats and it is located in this particular region. So apart from this Jerdon's Couser, we are having panthers, sloth bear, cheetal. Cheetal is a type of a deer, sambar, etc. So this is, okay, I didn't put the map of Sri Lankameshwara. Okay, I just missed the map, I think. Okay. So Sri Lankameshwara Wildlife Sanctuary is located in Andhra Pradesh, in the Kadapa region. So I'll draw the map. If there is no map, I can also draw the map. So this is the Andhra map roughly. In this Andhra, it is located in the Kadapa region like this. Okay. So next we are having Vikramashila Dolphin Sanctuary. So Vikramashila Dolphin Sanctuary is the only aquatic sanctuary of India. So aquatic sanctuary, river aquatic. We are having a marine sanctuary in Gulf of Mannar. And this is a aquatic sanctuary in the river Ganga, which is exclusively dedicated for protection of gangetic dolphins. So the Bihar government is setting up India's first observatory for the mammals in the Bhagalpur district. That is Vikramashila gangetic dolphin sanctuary. In this Vikramashila gangetic dolphin sanctuary, they are setting up observatory na, and the animals on the they can observe from there. So Prime Minister also announced a Project Dolphin in the last year's Independence Day speech. Prime Minister announced Project Dolphin, Project Tiger Mari. We are going to launch a project called Project Dolphin, where we are going to focus on protection of dolphins, because dolphin is the national aquatic animal of India. Since tiger is a national animal, we started to protect it. So we wanted to protect it. We declared it as a national animal. We launched the Project Tiger. So similarly, it is a national aquatic animal. We wanted to launch the project for this. And it got approval in December 2019 in the Ganga, National Ganga Council. National Ganga Council is headed by Prime Minister. National Ganga Council gave the approval for the protection. This gangetic dolphin is a endangered species and a Schedule 1 species. It is also Planetista gangetica. These are generally blind. So these species are blind. They generally use the ultrasonic echolocation. Ultrasonic sound echolocation, which is what they will be doing. So many dolphins, riverine dolphins, are generally blind. They are also called a susu. Yeah, the susu nu solranga and the susu nu sound vandukite irukum adukitta irundhu, because when they are breathing, they will be giving that sound. It is also a national aquatic animal. The decision was taken by National Ganga River Basin Authority in 2009. In 2009, Dr. Manmohan Singh announced it as a national aquatic animal. That organization was called as Ganga River Basin Authority. So this authority only was changed into National Ganga Council. So it is a 50 kilometer stretch. So Vikramashila Dolphin Sanctuary is a stretch of a river Ganga. Ganga river la or stretch matter or 50 kilometer stretch matter eduthukitte, and they have declared it as a dolphin sanctuary. It is also having smooth coated otter species irukku. Gharials is also located in this particular region. Apart from the dolphin, we are also having the turtles, freshwater turtles, and 135 species of waterfowl. Waterfowls means birds. So this is the location. This Vikramashila is located in Bihar. Okay, so Bihar la irukkira Ganga la vandu it is located, and this is the zoomed image. So it is located, Vikramashila, in the map. And if you could zoom here, this is Sultanganj, Bhagalpur and Kahalgaon. So from Sultanganj to Kahalgaon, this stretch is called as Vikramashila Dolphin Sanctuary. In the stretch of the Ganga river, they are protecting this dolphins. And the last protected area of the entire series is Ranthambore National Park of Rajasthan. six tigers are missing in the Ranthambore National Park, that is Tiger Sanctuary. So it is also having tigers there, and six tigers suddenly miss aayiduchu kaanam poiduchu. So Ranthambore Tiger Reserve lies in the eastern part of the Rajasthan in the state. So it is also part of Aravalli and Vindhya. So it is located in the exact junction of Aravallis and Vindhya. So north la Aravalli irukum, south la Vindhyas irukum. It comprises of Ranthambore National Parks and Savai Mansingh Sanctuary and Kailadevi Sanctuary. So Ranthambore National Park is consisting of Ranthambore Tiger Sanctuary, Savai Mansingh Wildlife Sanctuary and Kailadevi Wildlife Sanctuary. So Ranthambore Fort is located within this particular part. So Ranthambore is part of the Chauhan dynasty. Chauhan dynasty they constructed this fort called Ranthambore Fort in 944 AD. This fort is also located inside this particular park. Okay, it is having fragmented forest patches. So it is not having continuous patch, it is having fragmented forest and ravines. Ravines na vandu it is bad land nu solvanga. Bad land na this region is highly eroded by the rivers there. Badland, it is not fit for agriculture, not fit for any economic activities. So andamari or region. So in the this region will also be shown in the badland topography was shown in the movie called Dheeran movie la that gang will be located in this, and the gang kaatuvaangala and the region da vandu ravine region. So it is connected to Puno Phalpur landscape. So Puno Phalpur wildlife sanctuary is located in the Madhya Pradesh. In the Madhya Pradesh side la, in the side la, in Rajasthan border la, we are having this Ranthambore, and these two are connected by Kailadevi Wildlife Sanctuary. So it is a continuous protected area, and it is also a tiger corridor. So Ranthambore la tiger will come to Kuno Phalpur la tiger will go there. It is a common tiger corridor, and Chambal River is also flowing here. Chambal River creates a lot of ravine. It is having tropical dry deciduous tree called dhak. So dhak ingra tree is located. So dhak is a special tree which grows in the arid region. So this dhak tree is located here. Okay, it is a deciduous tree. So other animals la vandu rhesus, macaws, jackals, jungle cats, etc. You just have a look at here. Hanuman langur is located here, and it is also having this particular species called this dhak is capable of withstanding long period of drought, and it is also called as flames of forest. Idha vandu duck species. In the duck species la they will be having red color flowers. This duck species having red color flowers is also called as flames of forest. Idhe flames of forest nu solranga na dooratla irundhu paatha this red color flowers will look like fire. So adanal vandu it is called as flames of forest. So which of the following trees are called as flames of forest? There can be a question. This flames of forest, a particular tree species, is found in which of the following protected area? That is Ranthambore National Park. In the mari dimensions we can get a question. So note down the name of this flora also. So this is the map of the Rajasthan. In this Rajasthan we are having Ranthambore here, and Kuno Phalpur is located in this particular region of Madhya Pradesh, and we are having Kailadevi here. This Kailadevi is acting as a transition zone between these two areas because it is a contiguous zone. In the line ala humans potadu forest, there is no border. And tigers are using it as a tiger corridor also. So just note down the protected areas. And here we are having Sariska. We saw about this Sariska in the when we are discussing about the Asholabatti. So from this Sariska to Asholabatti only we are having this leopard corridor. If you could remember, I was discussing in the second protected area of the same video. Okay, go back and see again. Sariska is located in Rajasthan. So thank you guys. With this note, we have come to the end of the entire 50 protected areas in the new series. Successfully completed this series for the second year, and last year this series was a very big hit, and I hope this year also you guys will be benefited after seeing this series, and we let us hope that we are getting at least 2 to 3 questions from this particular area and getting all the 6 or 8 marks. Okay.